direct from Los Angeles, the Auto Channel presents exclusive press pass coverage of the 2007 LA Auto Show.
Straight from Fairbanks, Alaska, traveling 2,300 miles in 7 days, the Alcan FCHV. Gentlemen, Toyota Division, Group Vice President and General Manager, Bob Carter.
Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon and welcome to the 2007 Los Angeles Auto Show. We're very happy that you're here with us today to stage the world premiere of the second generation 2008 Sequoia and to give you an update on the significant achievements regarding our ongoing hydrogen hybrid fuel cell development program. We'll begin the program today with the most obvious, our Highlander fuel cell. Last September, Toyota engineers successfully drove a test vehicle powered by the next generation hybrid fuel cell from Osaka, Japan to Tokyo on a single 70 megapascal tank of compressed hydrogen gas. The vehicle was driven on public highways and covered a distance of 348 miles with sufficient fuel remaining in the tank to cover an additional 137 miles. The point of the drive was to demonstrate a new extended range capabilities of the next generation fuel cell stacks under normal and everyday driving conditions. Equally important was to show how the development of the hydrogen fuel cell powertrains continues to move forward and mature at an impressive rate, far in advance of any infrastructure that's necessary to support these type of vehicles. When our product planners and engineers heard about TMC's plans for its run from Osaka to Tokyo, they thought it was a great idea. But then they thought it probably didn't go far enough in showing how far this new system has been advanced. Traveling a distance of more than 300 miles is a significant goal because it's considered typical and the acceptable range for most gasoline-powered vehicles on the road today. However, the range capability, this new system has been developed to deal with two major challenges in the refinement of this new fuel cell powertrain. That is, starting and operating in cold temperatures and standing up to the vibration and harshness and rough road conditions over long distances over a long period of time. Our product development group informed TMC that they plan to demonstrate the reliability, durability, cold weather operation, and the extended range of the new system by driving from Fairbanks, Alaska to Vancouver, British Columbia, 2,300 miles, 7 days along the Alaska Highway. Every mile of the journey was monitored real time by a laptop program that measured the distance, the time, the speed, and the hydrogen fuel cell temperature, as well as fuel consumption. The entire trip was shot in high definition video. And to verify and chrono the achievement, we invited road and track engineering editor Dennis Simonitis with us to come along and referee as well as co-drive. One of the key reasons why our engineers chose the route from Fairbanks to Vancouver is that Canada allows mobile high-pressure refueling of hydrogen vehicles along its public highways. In the U.S., it's not allowed. Without a network of gas-and-go quickie marts, with hydrogen pumps every 300 miles, mobile refueling was necessary. Two companies were enlisted to insist. Linde provided the rolling supply of hydrogen, while PowerTech Labs supplied a self-contained refueling station. Mounted on two separate flatbed trucks, the refueling team moved in advance of the Highlander, setting up shop at predetermined intervals, while a pair of Tundras were following as support. Now, as you can guess, nothing went wrong, or perhaps we wouldn't be talking about it this morning. The first leg of the drive was the most suspenseful. The caravan needed to travel 316 miles from Fairbanks to Beaver Creek across the Canadian border in order to legally refuel at a truck stop parking lot of Buckshot Betty's Motel, the accommodations for the night. On the second and third day, from Beaver Creek to Whitehorse, and then from Whitehorse to Mucho Lake, the group covered the most remote sections of the Yukon Territory. With it came the roughest patches of highway, the coldest weather, and the most numerous encounters with herds of elk, goat, and caribou that often slowed the pace of the drive down to a crawl. And whether sharing the road with an unimpressed group of buffalo or sailing a vast open stretch of tundra at 90 miles per hour, the Highlander fuel cell performed without a glitch. 7 days, 2,300 miles. TMC Engineering was at first reluctant to agree to subject our prototypes to such a severe test. One man had the faith in the plan because he had faith in the vehicle, and he was the one that mattered most. 1 week before the Osaka to Tokyo run, our chief engineer, Yoshi Ishiguro, flew to the Yukon to take part in our All-Can project. And he's here with us today. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce our chief engineer, Ishiguro. Ishiguro-san. Thank you for the support. Now, with any new technology, anyone would like to be first to market, including us. But Toyota, we believe it's much more important to be best in market. Most importantly, it's critical that our 10 years of equity that we have built up in consumer confidence with hybrids is not diminished as we roll out other forms of advanced technology. The Alcon project is an example of how Toyota goes about its business of advanced vehicle development. And as was with the first Prius more than 10 years ago, and each of the more than 1 million hybrids we've sold since, our fuel cell program has been developed entirely in-house. Doing so is very expensive, and it's time-consuming in the beginning, but it ensures that we have a direct line to all phases of the R&D, and in the end, we believe it provides a higher quality, more reliable, and more affordable product. Here's another recent example. 5 days ago, we delivered the first two factory-developed Prius plug-in hybrid vehicles to the University of California, Berkeley, and the University of California, Irvine. The universities will conduct both technical and market research on these vehicles in real-world conditions, thus playing a major role in the eventual market preparedness of this new emerging technology. And although plug-in hybrids show promise, there's still many technical challenges that need to be met. And after 10 years of convincing customers that they don't need to plug in a Prius, we need to know how they're going to react when you have to connect it daily. No doubt about it, mainstream America has embraced hybrid technology. Last week, we began shipping the second generation Highlander hybrid midsize SUVs to our dealerships nationwide. The new Highlander hybrid will join the Camry hybrid and Prius and will account for over 250,000 sales this year. Yet hybrids still make up less than 1% of the total number of vehicles sold in the U.S. Now, as vital and important as plug-in hybrids, fuel cells may be to our future, the majority of the U.S. market will be driven in the short and the midterm by consumers that are seeking conventional trucks and SUVs. And there's no one better positioned to meet these needs than Toyota's. Of the six SUVs in our lineup, three are all new this year, while two others, the RAV4 and the FJ, are less than 2 years old. Of the vehicles that are all new this year, our second generation Sequoia will arrive last, but certainly not least. Buyers of large SUVs tend to be loyal, with about half of them returning back to the segment. And despite the rise in fuel prices, many buyers have no alternative to full-size SUVs. These are the active families who desire styling, utility, and a broad range of capability that a mid-SUV or van cannot provide. Their favorite pastimes are typically taking outdoor adventures with family and friends. In the U.S., planning an outdoor adventure typically requires a people hauler with a large, comfortable seating, cargo space for your gear, and the performance capability to travel to various terrains. And the new Sequoia will deliver all of that. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to introduce to you the all-new, second-generation Toyota Sequoia. The all-new Sequoia has undergone a dramatic change. Thank you. It's changed in every imaginable category, but the basic concept remains the same. People who buy full-size SUVs typically need a full-size SUV. And for the recreational travel with family and friends and equipment on the inside and a boat in tow on the outside. And that's usually at the top of their list. We know well how Americans operate on their vacations. They pack everything they need inside, with typically a little bit more, and that within the cabin they need to be comfortable, safe, secure, and they require the personalized entertainment for everyone on board. Most importantly, they're fearless in their attempts to cover as much ground as possible in a single day. That's why our Sequoia chief engineer, Arias-san, devised and implemented what he termed a 1,000-mile-a-day concept. On the open road, 1,000 miles in one day is a major chunk of real estate, translating to about 14 hours behind the wheel on a wide-open interstate. Bless you. Admittedly, this is not a typical drive for a typical family. It is, however, what Chief Engineer Arias-san considered within the limits of how many American road warriors attack long-distance driving. In practical terms, a 1,000-mile-a-day concept requires a powertrain that's capable of towing 10,000 pounds and delivering fuel economy along with a major reduction in NVH. It also requires a high rigidity chassis with straight line stability and low NVH, coupled with the comfort and control of a fully independent rear suspension. It also requires the best-in-class turning radius to complement the new and incredibly smooth variable flow steering system. And it would also require a new prioritization of seat design, comfort, and positioning in all three rows for all eight passengers. Long-distance traveling is an American phenomenon. While it's not unique to America, I believe Americans invented it and have refined it to an art form. Simply put, everything about the new Sequoia was based on achieving the ultimate statement in long-distance transportation. The new 2008 Sequoia rides on an all-new platform, is completely redesigned both inside and out, and offers a significantly more powerful 5.7 V8 engine. The new engine produces 381 horsepower, 401 foot-pounds of torque, which is one of the highest outputs in its class. It's mated to an all-new 6-speed automatic transmission, providing the 2008 Sequoia with an excellent acceleration and available towing capacity of 10,000 pounds. Now, even with the significant increase of 108 horsepower, Sequoia's fuel efficiency has been improved by nearly 12% over its previous model, and it will be ULEV 2 compliant. And in the fall of 2008, Sequoia will be offered with a new flex fuel option. A primary design goal of the new Sequoia was to ensure the driver and the passengers, regardless of their size, have sufficient space and room and comfort. In fact, Sequoia will be spacious enough to comfortably accommodate well above normal height adults in each of its 8 seats. But please don't take my word for it. After the press conference today, I would encourage you to come up and climb in and out of the second and third rows. We don't think any vehicle in the class comes close to the roominess, comfort, and ease of ingress and egress as the new Sequoia. Standard safety includes Toyota's Star Safety System, as well as driver and passenger seat-mounted side airbags and 3-row roll-sensing side curtain airbags. Since its launch, Sequoia has maintained the youngest buyers in its segment with an average age of only 40, with nearly 60% of Sequoia owners being married with children. We believe Sequoia's 3-grade strategy will help attract a wider and more diverse buyer group. SR5, with its lower price, will appeal to young families and couples. The limited grade will appeal to more established families and a diverse group looking for a higher level of comfort and amenities. And finally, we see the new Platinum grade attracting mature customers and established families that are seeking more refinement and comfort in their SUVs. Pricing of all 3 grades will be announced in about 2 weeks, with vehicles arriving at our dealerships in the end of December, right around the holiday season. In closing, I would first like to recognize the man who spent many 1,000-mile days behind the wheel of the new Sequoia throughout its development. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to introduce the chief engineer, Mr. Araya. Araya-san, thank you for joining us. Finally, here at the 100th anniversary of the LA Auto Show, we've had the opportunity to give you a glimpse of both the present and the future of the automobile business. More to the point, the Highlander hydrogen hybrid fuel cell vehicle and the all-new second-generation Sequoia are vehicles that represent what it means to be a full-line manufacturer today while preparing for the major challenges in our industry in the very near future. Fuel cells, plug-in hybrids, pure electrics, lithium-ion batteries, and much, much more are all going to be part of our future. And it's going to require more than just building and selling cars. It's going to require a whole new way that we do business. Over the next months, we at Toyota will have much more to say about the exciting new future of the auto business. Mr. Araya-san, Mr. Ishiguro, and I will be happy to answer any questions you may have about these 2 products. For now, please join me on stage to take a closer look and enjoy the rest of the show. Thank you.
Thanks for watching The Auto Channel. For more press pass coverage of the LA Auto Show and all other major auto shows, visit theautochannel.com. The Internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive information resource.